Yells.
Hey guys, Wade Grotta here, playing a little bit of Zyba Tower? Zyba Tower? Zyba Tower? Anyways, playing with the M5K. Probably my most favorite gun of the expansion packs. There are quite a few with the Battlefield Premium, however, I do prefer. This is a rusher's gun, so if you like the MP7, if you like the P90, and if you'd like a few other guns of that type of rushing around and just spraying everybody, this is the one you want to try to unlock first. Now at this point I do have a holographic sight, laser and extended mags, and of course laser so I can get a little better hip fire, and extended magazines. This gun, just like the MP7, desperately needs the extended magazines, so it is a must. You can see right there, I had a little trouble taking down that guy despite several hits. But new maps, man, a lot of fun. I will tell you, for those of you who don't have them yet, but if you haven't downloaded them yet or whatever the case may be, some of you guys will like them, some of you guys won't. I think hardcore Battlefield guys who only play Battlefield are not gonna really appreciate them as much as of us guys who play other games like, you know, and Medal of Honor and Homefront and Call of Duty and stuff like that. To me, and I said this to Al Knight and Laguna and a couple other guys when we were playing tonight, if Medal of Honor Warfighter is like this, I will be absolutely tickled. I think this is really the way Medal of Honor should be. You know, there's no vehicles, it's running around, it's gun on gun, you're done. You know, it's really cool weapons, it's high destruction, and where you going, man? Hello. But you know, I just think if Medal of Honor is like this, it's gonna be a huge success. And this is the type of thing that Call of Duty probably should have done a long time ago. You see right there, I got my first M5K proficiency tag, so I got my first 100 kills with the M5K. I keep wanting to see MP5K. But sorry, it's a little late right now, but I wanted to bring you guys something before I went to bed. That guy's name is Wake Pulse. There will be no invitations accepted, especially on my server. And for those of you who don't know, I do have my own PS3 server, and right now I do have it set up where it has the new maps in rotation, and also with a shuffle of game modes. So, you know, it could be TDM, could be Conquest, or whatever the case may be, but it is a shuffle of map rotation and also game mode. So we had a lot of fun on it tonight. I actually got a couple messages, you know, hey, you had a lot of fun on your server, and hey, is this your server? It's a lot of fun. So, you know, I take that as a compliment, because, you know, it does take a little bit of time and stuff to set up, and of course you pay a little bit of coin to get this thing going, but you know, I think it worked out pretty good, and I'll probably have the new maps on there for quite some time, until I decide to go ahead and try to tweak it a little bit and, you know, add this and add that. You can see right there the hip fire is very proficient on this weapon, just like the MP7. Like I said, I think it actually looks really cool though. I just like that. I mean, I used I used MP5s and MP5Ks and MP3s and all that stuff a lot in other first-person shooters, so it's really cool to have this variant inside of there. It, you know, I think this particular gun is something maybe the game was actually missing from launch, so it's nice to be able to see this in a DLC, and hopefully we see other cool guns in DLC as well. I unlocked almost everything. I need like 3 more grenade kills, and I unlocked the Scar L. The Scar H. I unlocked almost every gun. So I got all the sniper rifles and everything, and of course, I'll do another video like I did to the Bacta-Carcan weapons, where, you know, I give you a little bit of tidbits about the weapons as well as to show you how to unlock them. And unfortunately, I did not catch my EOD bot kill, but I did end up replicating almost exactly what I did with the EOD bot to go ahead and unlock the TAR-21, which seems to be a pretty nasty gun so far. I only have about 10 kills with it as I sit here right now, but man, that gun seems pretty freaking brutal. get headshotted, son. Headshotted hipfire. That RFE guy, he was one of the guys that actually emailed me on PSN and said, hey, I really like your server. Thanks a lot. I had a lot of fun tonight. So it's nice to hear that type of stuff. You see, of course, I'm playing against my buddy Law Dog, and on my server, I get to play with and against a lot of you guys, playing with Ghost Rider, Laguna Blue, I think Al Knight's in here as well, and just a bunch of others. Now, is this some super, like, 40-0, KD gameplay? No. It's just a fast-paced gameplay. I was in the mix a lot, and, you know, I was using this weapon. I just unlocked the extended magazines. I wanted to bring you guys a little bit of something and just show you so far my, kind of highlighting my favorite gun of the unlock. I'm sure within the next couple days I'll have more and better gameplay as we go forward here. But, this is not too shabby. And I got some really good Conquest gameplay as well. Conquest Domination gameplay. So I'm going to try to bring that to you guys too. I'll put a link to that video at the end. I'm going to upload it tonight. And I hope to wake up early tomorrow morning and do a little early bird commentary for you guys. So we can go ahead and check out another. It's on another map using a different weapon too. So I think that'd be really cool. Actually, I think it's with the RPK because I need to do that challenge. But a lot of fun, man. These new maps are great. Like I said, especially me coming from more of a Medal of Honor, background. And I still play Medal of Honor 2010 all the time, for those of you who don't know. But man, what a lot of fun these maps are. I mean, it's gun on gun. I don't got to worry about being chased down by a tank or a helicopter. Little spawn camp right there. I thought I had destroyed that beacon, but apparently I didn't. It's just a lot of fun. So I think you guys who really like high pace action, you like Grand Bazaar, you like Operation Metro. I think this is the type of game modes and maps that you guys are really gonna, have a lot of fun on. Now, for those of you guys who like Caspian Borders and Operation Firestorms and stuff like that, you may not particularly like this type of map and also game mode styles. But to each their own. Everybody can't love everything all the time. But I tell you what, I'm having a lot of fun on it. I think a lot of the guys I play with, we had a lot of fun on it too. Real happy about the Battlefield Premium, even though we're about 48 hours late. But I think it's gonna, in the long run, I think it's gonna be really awesome. I can tell you this much, it's better than Call of Duty Elite so far. You see, he ended up 18-6, so 3 KD. And I've got a shit ton of ribbons and all that stuff, of course. And got my first service star with the M5K. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed the video. Now, just as promised, if you can click the video on the left, and that will bring you to my other game mode on Scrap Yard, I think is what it's called. Forgive me here, I haven't learned the names yet. And then video from yesterday, from Homefront, is on the right. And of course, if you're new around here, please feel free to click subscribe, and that will bring all of my content, Battlefield 3, Medal of Warfare 3, Medal of Honors, just a total variety of FPSs right to your YouTube homepage. And of course, random will be something completely random. Feel free to click away, guys. Also, please feel free to check out some of my friends' channels. I'll put links to them down in the description. Thanks, guys.
Yells!